What's up, everybody? This is Nate Bargatze, the Nate Land Podcast. I'm here also because I was told to introduce you all. That's what, you know, someone said. Make sure we keep introducing everybody because no one knows who you guys are. That's what they said. Okay. That's what they specifically pointed you out, Aaron. No. I'm Nate. This is Aaron Weber, Brian Bates. So welcome to the show. The show's been doing good. So far, it's been fun, I think. We got good good responses. People been so far, people have been nice. I don't think anybody's been mean or, you know. That's all you're going for at this point, just not to be mean. I don't know. But it's been wonderful. Last week, we did an episode, on the money episode. And I wanted to start it off because we had, you know, I know a lot of people when they watch it, I'd imagine the most frustrating thing with the podcast is is not being able to like say something, like is like us just talking.
Yeah.
And then you're like, well, they don't know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
And then you got to just sit quiet, you know. That's got to be tough.
Yeah.
But I mean, just you should start your own podcast. That's what that person should. Just a podcast. It would be just a rebuttal podcast to every podcast they listen. That would be a pretty good idea for a podcast.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah, just be like, you just said guy, and this is, we're going to start it. If it's just me, I make sure the rebuttals are what I want them to be. It's like a dictatorship. Like, I'll just run it. I run all the media. But someone should. They do a podcast. Say they listen to every podcast, like, here's my thoughts on all their, you know. It's like commenting on podcasts.
I mean, that would take up that guy's whole life, probably, I mean, right?
Yeah, but podcast. But if he does good, it'd be his job.
Yeah.
You know? All right. well, we did pull some comments from Nate Land. Make sure you go to Nate Land, all the social media, Nate Land Podcast. If you want to get a hold of us, that's the best place to get it. I know a lot of people do my social media. I don't have social on my phone anymore. I still see some of it, but Nate Land Podcast, Bates is running, and I mean, he's got the time. He'll respond back probably quicker than you want it to be. I mean, responds where they go, whoa, take it easy, man. This guy's all...
Like, they hit send, and they're here, ding, wait, what?
Yeah, I've been waiting for this response. Who have you ever... Didn't we talk about responding to someone? I have a very funny... about being like overly excited about something. I got one time I got interviewed by TMZ when I landed at LAX, and it was, I mean, clearly nobody's there. So, and I was getting picked up, and so the car service had my name. And so I think the guy just like, obviously at first I'm like, wow, how did he know I was fine? And it's like, there's a guy with my name. Like, you know, the guy's just at the airport.
Yeah.
And he's just looking at names. And then, so he Googled me. And then walked me to the car and was asking. He was like, hey, this team's... Dude, I was so shocked by it. Like, it was not even...
Were you into it? Did it feel good?
Yeah. But I mean, I was never even a million years thinking, like, this is going to happen. Like, I, you know, I'm not worried about, like, you know, I mean, like, you know, if you're Kim Kardashian, like, or even someone big, you're expecting it. And I've seen it. I've been with guys that are big where, like, I've seen them come up. And then I was with David Spade once, and he got kind of pounded outside this restaurant. And then I had one guy that kind of knew me out with that David Spade, and it was his first day. That's what he told me. It was his first day at TMZ, and I'm like, "Well, you don't need to be talking to me, man. If you want to make it in this business, David Spade is right there. You should go. What are you doing? I'm just giving him advice on how to.
Well, he's practicing on you.
He just gave it out.
Well, you're day one at TMZ. You can't show up with Nate Bargatze clips. It's like, this is the guy we hired.
This is the Who is this? But the guy at LAX, so he walked with me and was just asking. He walked me to the car, and I talked the whole time. And I honestly think by the time he left me at the end of it. He was like, all right, man. I was like, you sure we got everything? You want to do a couple more? Like, you want to ride with me? Where are you going, dude? You need a ride somewhere? Like, he's like, nah, I think I'm fine, dude. I think we got it. And then just left. And I was overly excited that it was happening.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah, I've certainly had email exchanges where they end it with me. Like, the last comment's me. You could tell they're just done.
Yeah.
And they don't reply. We've had, like, at least one person, like, reach out and I know more about them than they do about me.
Yeah. Who was, yeah.
It was just like, he's like, hey, you probably don't remember me. I met you in Huntsville. And I was like, it was actually Birmingham.
Yeah. Yeah. Brian corrected him.
Yeah. He was like, oh, yeah, you're right.
You're right. I'm sorry. I completely forgot. Who is this again? And then you're just like, John, it's Brian. Come on, man. Like, I've been keeping up with you. How's the kids? Like, he's like, all right, this is too much.
How was Ethan's birthday?
Yeah. So that's, you're like Michael Scott that just knows all the sales calls. Michael Scott always knows all everybody's
flashcards.
Yeah.
Did your son make varsity this year?
Yeah. So that's what, and all we're saying is very engaged on social media if you reach out to the Nate Land podcast. So we were looking at some of the comments. So we're going to go through because some people commented on the last week's episode. One of them, apparently Aaron, is unbelievable at the piano. You were downplaying it. That's what someone commented. Said, I know it's fun to clown on Weber. I don't know. I mean, I don't remember clowning. Like,
well, we were making fun of him.
We were having a good time.
Fine. Yeah.
I like that guy's like, look, I get it, dude. I love it. You love it. We all love clowning on Weber. Totally understandable. But, and that's Aaron Weber. Got to reintroduce him just so everybody knows. But he's actually being really modest here. I spent a few years as a professional musician making income off of that craft. And I've seen Aaron play piano. Boy can play out of them keys. And he said, I'm serious. What? So you can play the piano really good?
I can play okay. I'm curious who that is and where they've seen me play.
Oh, come
on,
Aaron. You know who that is.
You know it is.
You posted that, I bet.
Yeah. I don't know.
I saw the comment.
You got a
fiance. Oh, you didn't know the guy.
I did. No, I clicked on it. I tried to figure out who it is. I don't know where he saw me play piano.
Now you didn't. Now you're not acknowledging him. So I'm sure we're going to get another comment to go, you know what? Turns out it wasn't Aaron. Yeah. Well, Aaron, we got a piano and Krispy Kreme donuts coming in right now. Everybody, welcome to the car. We do have a piano downstairs. My daughter's taking piano
lessons.
Do you
really?
Yeah.
I'll play it later. I haven't played a piano in a long time.
All right. Well, I'd love to play. We're showing little Instagram stories.
There you go.
So check that out, and you can see Aaron playing the piano. See if this guy is right.
Okay.
You better come out the gate.
That's a really nice comment. Thank you, whoever wrote that.
Yeah. Guy commenting on nothing but you being funny. So
that's true. Yeah.
Your actual profession now.
Yeah, as a comedian, not great, but yeah. Musician.
Piano, really dropped the ball. Another one, someone commented, they used to live around the corner from Brad Pitt. I'd see him in the grocery store, out walking alone, always said hey, or stop to chat about whatever. A totally regular guy. There's a big difference between celebrities and people who act for a living. So we talked about Brad Pitt. Does he mow his own grass?
Yep.
And that's pretty cool. I like to hear that. Brad Pitt comes up. You know, you can tell when a celebrity, you feel like they're like, oh, I bet he's like a regular dude. Like,
yeah.
I'm not. And even we're joking about him. Of course he doesn't mow his own grass. Can't do anything. But you can tell when, you know, like. Because sometimes when people become celebrities, I think they can become like monsters. Like they're delusional. They're just, I don't know, they have that personality. And I mean, not that we don't know Brad Pitt at all, but like just when you see interviews and you see him talk, you're like, oh, I bet he's a, you know, when I could tell he was a cool dude, do you ever see the Jackass thing where he went on Jackass?
I don't remember
when
that.
They were on MTV.
Yeah.
So this is I mean, they're new, I think. Like, okay. They're just on MTV. I mean, they're kind of, people know they are, but it's not like.
No movies yet?
I don't think any movies yet.
Yeah.
And so he's at Pink's Hot Dog, and he agreed to do this. So he goes to Pink's Hot Dog, and he's standing in line, and you see people kind of looking at him like, that's crazy. It's Brad Pitt just getting a hot dog. And then the Jackass crew pulls up in a van and kidnaps him.
I do remember that.
They go, wow. See if you look it up on YouTube. Just to,
it's outdoor hot it's dog outdoor, stand. Yeah.
Outdoor hot dog stand. And I mean, truly, like, it's the greatest acting in the world. Like, it's I mean, it's for someone right there, Brad, right, that third one.
Brad Pitt kidnapped. Yeah.
29 seconds.
I mean, yeah.
I mean, look how much he's like. Look at that. That's like real deal.
I would think that was real 100%.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, can you imagine? Like, I mean, for that moment, yeah. those people are like, we're a part of history.
Yeah.
Our most famous celebrity just got kidnapped.
Wow.
For him to agree to do that, and then that, I mean, just the commitment to do it. I'm a big fan of commitment. If you see someone committing, like, where I really am, like, something like that acting, because it's very easy to be like, dude, I'm not going to, I'll kind of pretend like you grabbed me.
Yeah.
Like, for him to be grabbing the top of the van, help, like, screaming like that. I mean, he's the best, dude.
It's curious, interesting to see what people did, like bystanders did when that happened.
Well, they called the cops, and that
they called the cops, but like nobody. I mean, it was a group of people kidnapping him, but nobody really jumped in to stop.
One guy kind of did. That's like when you see anything, and everybody's all like, they're like, "Why didn't you go in to help?" And you're like, "Dude, any crazy moment someone's in, you're not. You can't imagine you're seeing the moment.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're not." So when you're seeing that happen, like there's no, that's like anything, dude.
And when you're still processing it.
Yeah, like when anybody says, "Well, why did, if I was there, I would," you're like, dude, you probably wouldn't have. You have no idea, like what would a, you can't wrap your head around what's happened. No one, I mean, how many like times do anybody see anything like something like a kidnapping or like, I mean, a murder, like any of that stuff? You're just most people. It's almost like you have lottery odds of actually witnessing that kind of act. And so you don't think that could ever happen.
Uh-huh.
So you have no, like, you're just going to sit there and just, that one guy kind of tried to, like, go and help, but, like.
Let alone it being Brad Pitt, you know? Like you were saying, Brad, they're probably just still processing the fact that this huge celebrity's right there.
Yeah.
You don't even know what's happening.
And now he's getting kidnapped.
Yeah.
If that guy just, like, Brad Pitt just got kidnapped and, like. Yeah, what are you going to say? Yeah. It's like, what? There, I mean, Brad Pitt, like, I mean, you, even if someone told you that.
Yeah.
To go, what?
Imagine being the 911 operator.
Yeah. Who?
Oh, Brad Pitt got kidnapped?
Did he?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, wow. Heard this one before. next thing you tell me, he was mowing his grass.
Did you ever hear the 911 call when the guy that O.J. Simpson robbed called?
No.
In Vegas?
Yeah.
He called, he was like, O.J. Simpson just robbed me. And they were like, yeah, okay, dude.
Yeah.
O.J. Simpson? All right.
I mean, you think they would be like, okay, maybe. All right.
Yeah, I can see
I'm listening. Like, they would. It's not, like Brad Pitt is like, but O.J. robbed me. There's no, come on. You can tell me O.J.'s going to do something like that? Is that what you're trying to tell me? O.J., all the stuff I've seen him do, you'll tell me that he's going to rob you. Like, you're like, well, it's kind of Kate. I mean, it's possible.
Yeah.
Two more little quick comments. The other one is, why do rental companies charge so much for gas? This guy used to work at Hertz. Rental places charge so much for gas because you're paying for the labor of them sending someone to fill it up at the car at the gas station so it's full for the next customer. And I get that. But you're paying for that labor. I just wish you could give them. It should be like you have to give the guy $20. That's what I think would be better than charging. Like it's normal gas prices.
Yeah.
But if you do it, there's a $20 fee that goes straight to the kid that has to go fill.
Is that more than the difference of what you're paying? $20?
Maybe. I mean, it's like $6. Well, it's probably like $6 a gallon to fill it up. So whatever that.
Really?
Would be.
Is it that high?
For if you wait.
Yeah.
I mean, they. You know. So it's like you can do like that's what it's saying. Avis does a thing now. You can just you got to just send it to them empty. But if you click it before and say like I want them to fill it up, you don't have to pay that fee. But you're like already agreeing to like do that.
Okay.
But I'd rather just give the guy $20.
Yeah.
I bet you could do that. I bet you could be like, hey, I didn't fill it up, but here's a 20.
Just under the table.
Table 20.
Yeah.
I bet anything you can do that.
Mm-hmm.
And they'd be like, all right, thanks. And they would just go fill it up. I mean, there's no way for them. You know, they're going to a regular gas station. It's not like they're going to a special.
For some reason, I thought they had, like, their own gas. I'm so dumb. I didn't even think about them going to an actual gas station.
I could have seen that. Like, at the airport, they even have, like, a thing that fills up gas.
Yeah, that's like, what I thought it was.
Yeah, I could see that. But I bet you could go just give the guy $20.
Yeah.
I think someone should try it. Everybody.
I feel like that's the case with most things. Most places like that, you just give people money. They can do pretty much whatever you ask them to do.
A 20 goes a long way.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you can get away with the 20, you can get a lot of Mm-hmm. A lot of extra out of it. The last one, why do some gas stations charge more for gas? Most gas stations that are absurdly expensive don't hold as much gas as other stations, so they run out faster but charge more to overcompensate. I mean, I don't, why can you not just have more gas? I guess they don't have enough pumps.
Is it the pumps that's the issue, or is it the
holding
tank?
The holding tank, probably.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a business decision that I don't know how smart.
Yeah, that's
that
on
is.
Them. I don't know why they're putting it on the customer.
Oh, my buddy texted me the gas thing that he did. The one that I was talking about that's in California, that's in like Beverly Hills, that's so crazy.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Yeah, like that, it doesn't seem like a good business, you know, I don't know if I can find this, but it doesn't seem like a good business thing. Why would you do that? You know, it doesn't matter.
Did you purposely skip the first two?
I was going to say.
Where?
At the top there.
I don't know if I can see. Oh. No, I didn't see them because the other ones were black. So, yes. Why is Nate's hand so orange? Iodine?
There was two comments, yeah.
Yeah. And does Nate wear hand makeup? I do not. So, I don't know. I actually saw that orange comment, and then I asked my wife. See, that's the deal. You guys say comments, and then you spin us in a... I mean, we just go down this spiral of, like, I think I have just cancer. Like, I think it's over. And as we've talked about, they haven't solved cancer. So we're in big trouble. But I... Like, saying, like, I don't have enough iron in my blood or something? Is that what that means?
No, I thought they meant you've been taking some iodine supplements. Yeah. That'll make your skin orange.
Oh. I have been golfing a ton, and in the sun... an absurd amount of time. So that's why I would say...
You don't wear gloves?
I don't wear gloves. You know, my Comedy Central Presents. So a big thing to do when I was in out of high school, and I did it till probably I was like 28, is you'd wear rubber bands around your wrist. And it was like Kevin Garnett did it, like Charles Barkley. All these NBA players did it. And so it was a huge thing to do. So I wore them until... I mean, honestly, like 28 years old, it was, I was like, I remember being 27 going, I just don't see why I would ever take these rubber bands off. I was that committed to, I mean, it would get caught like my wife's hair. My wife, I mean, she's dating like a child. Or married. We were married. She's married to a child. I used to also wear, I would, under every pair of pants or shorts, I wore shorts and boxers. So if I had jeans on, wow. I would have shorts, boxers. I mean, boxers, shorts, and then my jeans. And if I had shorts on, I would have boxers and then two pairs of shorts.
Why?
I did that. I don't know. It just was like we did it in high school. It was a big thing to wear. I have no idea.
I can't imagine having that much room.
I had you know, have all I mean, the room I'm, in the world.
Basketball game broke out, you'd be ready.
I've had a situation where we were playing basketball, and a guy go, I don't have shorts, and I go,
hey. Yeah, I got you.
And I swear to you, I gave him my outer shorts. I go, lucky for you, my friend, I have an extra pair on me, and literally on me, and then I gave him those pair.
That's hilarious.
It was, I mean, I don't know the reasoning behind why, you know, it was like, it was cool to do. The rubber band, like all that stuff was...
Did you buy rubber bands or did you just happen upon them?
I would buy... Yeah. I would go to Staples and buy a bag
of
them.
I'm going to try a thicker rubber band this time. Yeah, yeah.
And I would just switch them in and out. And it was... Mm-hmm. I mean, it was just like wearing... If someone wore a bracelet or something. Mm-hmm. And that we would do that. So anyway, so I wore them on my Comedy Central Presents. And a lot of people were asking me, they're like, is he wearing latex gloves? Because they would just see the rubber bands. And it looked like, you know, like it was the top
the end of
the...
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So it looked like, so people watched that Comedy Central Presents and just been like, this comic wears latex gloves when he performs. I was ahead of the COVID times. I knew it was coming that I did it. So no, I don't know if they're orange. They're, I mean, do they look orange? I don't know if it, maybe lighting the table can make it look more orange. Yeah. I'm also extremely tan.
I was going to say, you just got a tan. Golf. You've been outside playing golf.
I got a solid, solid tan. And then I got a great golfer's. I mean, it's like my feet are just looks like I have socks on. So that's it. So yeah, all right. Those are the questions. So yeah, when you watch an episode, you feel like you want to get something out on your chest, you know, just hit us up and we'll go through it.
Well, right. Another comment that we got, it was, why does the guy running the computer look like Stewart from The Big Bang Theory? which I'm going to guess they're talking about me.
Yeah.
And I've heard this. There's like three guys that I've been most often compared to. One of them, well, Stewart from Big Bang, which I didn't even know who he was. I didn't watch Big Bang, but that's him.
I can kind of see it, and I would understand if Stewart got upset about the comment. Like, I would be on Stewart, like that's one where you would, the Stewart would be like, all right, man, like, I do, that's, you're crazy. That's what he would say. And he would be, you know, offended. He's got more hair. Well, I don't know, he's got more hair, but he's doing it better than Brian. And then he's, I mean, you know.
He's got more casual look to him. Yeah. With the wardrobe.
That's a set from Big Bang Theory.
No.
Mine's a glamour shot.
Okay. That's fair.
Yeah.
If you're listening to this, I'll post this on social so you can
see. Was he a major character in that show, or was he?
I didn't watch Big Bang
Theory. I never watched it either.
My parents watched it.
It's the biggest show in America.
There's some episodes that are unbelievable. They did some. What was the? They broke down like Star Wars or something.
It was Raiders of the Lost Ark.
They like broke it down. It like changed. It was like a huge thing that they because they explained it in some, you know, nerdy way or whatever, and people like went crazy about it. But it was a huge show. I mean, shows, sitcoms, sitcoms still alive and doing great. I mean, it's an enormous show.
Yeah.
And this is a time where shows are they're rarely going to get
what's done
that
now.
Big anymore. Yeah, but I mean, it was still
it was
in
like
the time.
13 seasons, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was
but
crazy.
To be that big of a show nowadays,
have you gotten that before?
Yeah, I was
going
to say, if you hear it, just one random comment from someone you think they're just dumb or crazy. I've heard this a few times. All these I've heard a few times, so I guess I can't argue with it. The other one I heard, someone posted this yesterday too, Jamie from the Progressive commercials.
I mean, dude, I get this one too, but I think that Jamie guy, just from he looks, I think he's jacked.
That's like, why.
You think so?
I honestly do. Like, when you see those commercials, like if he wears like short sleeves, I'm pretty sure he's like pretty jacked. And I mean, yeah, if these two guys... I think it would be more if they said, "Is he your dad?" Like that's what they would feel if they would go.
Jamie's my dad.
No.
Yeah. If Jamie's your dad, him and Stewart, I mean, straight up, they should be like, if they would be less offended if he goes, "Hey, I think I met your dad once." Like, and then they would be like, "Ah, yeah, I get that," and they would feel good about it instead of going, "You know who you look like you know."
So all these,
I think he's jacked though. Like so.
So that's a compliment, Brian.
Well, the comments, some could call it bullying, but he's calling him his dad. So the ultimate bully is in the room right now.
Yeah.
It's worse than anybody online. But the one I get by far the most is this guy, Mike White.
Yeah.
Actor and director.
That one's crazy.
Mike White.
Yeah.
Brian,
that one I think you could be offended by.
So if you don't know this, he's most known, I think, for Jack Black's roommate in the School of Rock.
Yeah, that's how I know him.
But
yeah.
I've had so many people. I've had someone tell me at a class reunion that we saw you in a movie.
Yeah.
And we couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
And I've been on like radio shows. I was on Rick and Bubba once. They did not tell me ahead of time. They knew it wasn't, but we come back from a break and they're like, "All right, excited to have Jack Black's roommate from the School of Rock."
Are you serious?
No, they knew I wasn't him, but they.
Oh, okay.
I'm just saying, people say this a lot.
Yeah.
So then the ultimate, a friend of a friend of mine moved to LA, and I'd only met this guy a couple of times. His comic friend of mine, and he saw this guy Mike White in a restaurant and thought it was me and went up to him and said, "Hey man, so you living out here now?" He was like, "Yeah." He's like, "Oh, cool and then I think he finally realized, he's like, "You're Brian Bates, right?"
Yeah.
And he's like, "No," and he was offended. So this happens a lot.
That's so funny.
I mean, that's crazy for it happened to that guy.
Yeah.
Like that, he like all the work he's done. And then, I mean, you're Brian Bates. And he's like, "What?"
You always, what, you know, it's crazy that it happened the other way around.
Yeah.
You know? It happened to you. Yeah. It's like, yeah, it's crazy it's gotten to him. That's when you can tell it's a close resemblance.
For sure.
When it gets to him.
Yeah.
All right, here's some with Aaron.
All right, so we've already talked about this on the podcast, people you look like. John Candy.
Yeah.
You see
I
it?
Can see that. I can see that. Yeah, that's a weird picture of him, I feel like. Like, that's me on my best day, and that's him going through some stuff.
That's like...
No, you did a good job picking two similar pictures. Yeah. It's just...
He got pulled out of his house immediately. That's what that looks like. That looks like, I mean, he was not planning on going outside.
No.
And then immediately forgot, I have a wedding to go to. And then had to...
Throw on a suit.
Yeah.
And that's me at my best with
Aaron
stage lighting.
Groomed.
Yes. I just got a haircut.
Paid the guy to come take the picture there.
No, brand new shirt.
So if you're listening, you probably know what John Candy looks like. You probably don't know what Aaron looks like. So just imagine if John Candy was homeless for a few months. That's what we're looking at here.
That's a good one. Yeah, I've gotten that one a lot.
All right. John Goodman.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could... Yeah. The reason I think that compares me and John Goodman is not that great. I don't know what John Goodman looks like when he was my age, just because I feel like every image of him
definitely
in my head
better,
is when he's older.
But you think he was a movie star at your age, I think.
Was he a movie star by
probably
age?
He was on Roseanne. Probably
Roseanne, not when he was my age. He wasn't.
He was in his 30s, I bet.
Yeah.
You think he was in his 30s back then?
Well, gosh, that show was 30 years ago, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but he was like a father of a family.
Well, you should be.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess.
All right. And then the other one that we haven't talked about before, but you tell me, Luke Combs. If you don't know him, country singer Luke Combs.
Yeah. I mean, this is every fat guy with a beard in Nashville gets compared to Luke Combs, who is a tremendously successful country singer.
Is he the most successful fat guy with a beard? Is he
right now? I would say
in the
probably
game.
I can't think of another.
If y'all had a conference, like he would be who's speaking? Like Luke Combs, you're like, oh, wow.
He would be the keynote speaker at the fat bearded white guy conference for sure.
Yeah,
I'd be happy to get an invite. But yeah, I mean, I would never unbutton that many buttons on my shirt. But
you're buttoned up there.
If I was as successful as him, I'd probably do it.
That's the confidence he has. Is like he's representing so many guys.
That's right.
That he's like, well, I got to step it up, and then he has confidence to unbutton those shirts.
Look at me, I got a jacket on.
Yeah,
I got the other way.
Yeah, he's getting. Well, he's starting. It's gonna come back down for him once you start doing that. And if he remains a big dude, I get it. I can't wear unbuttoned things like him doing that look on. I've seen. I know a lot of guys that do that where they leave their button down to the chest. Like you see it more where you're like, I shouldn't see this much.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I always think when I see guys unbuttoned. I think I shouldn't. I should be like, oh, I don't know if I've seen someone. That's my comment. And it should be like, no, I actively see people, guys do that.
Yeah.
And it's like older guys, you know, if they're 20, it's one thing, you know, that's completely different.
Yeah. If you're like a Kennedy on a sailboat, you know, maybe you have one button on a shirt. But if you're, you know, I would button all the way up to the top if that wasn't considered lame.
I do sometimes.
Guys, golf shirts, I feel like you can...
being crazy.
You got Brian's leather loose, man.
Nobody wants to see that.
Golf shirt, I feel like it's common to go all the way up to the top, isn't it?
But
like just a button down,
well, I don't.
It looks
I do
weird.
Some shirts, but that I'll go like this one is like half... Yeah, you button up, though. I feel uncomfortable when it's like that.
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't. All right.
And what was the... There was a story of someone at a wedding that mistakes you for someone?
Oh, yeah. I did a... in college, my sister's wedding, this old woman, I don't know who she was, she met me and she goes, were you in a Hallmark commercial? And I was like, no.
Yeah.
And then I saw her like later that weekend. She was like, are you sure you never did a Hallmark? I was like, I'd probably remember if I was in a major commercial. And she goes, you look just like this guy from a Hallmark commercial. You got to look it up. And then I saw her again and she told me about it. I was like, I must look exactly like this
guy. Did you look it up?
I looked it up. The guy was enormous in the commercial. It looked nothing like me. And the upsetting part is I looked at the commercial again recently and the guy, he didn't look that big
to me. Do you have it?
No.
The commercial's called Brother of the Bride.
Did you find it on YouTube?
I did find it on YouTube. Yeah. And, at the time that I looked it up, he looked much bigger. But now we look a little more similar. And
Brother of the Bride.
Yeah, it's like the movie Heavyweights. I watched that movie Heavyweights recently, and I was like, those kids aren't that big.
Is this it?
Yeah, that's the one right there. Yeah, this is the one she was talking about.
All right.
I guess it was big at the time. Or it was a couple years old, but yeah, that guy.
That guy?
Yeah. See, now we look. Just pause. I mean, yeah, we're about the same size now. I might be bigger than him now.
Yeah.
I could see that.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You see it?
Maybe.
Did you have a beard at the time?
I didn't have a beard, and I had a tux on the whole weekend.
Oh.
Well, that's you. So, that might, yeah. I think that might be you.
Yeah. You sure you didn't do a Hallmark commercial?
Oh, come on.
I didn't know. I mean, I could see. I could definitely see that. All right.
All right. That's.
Anyway.
Yeah, we don't have to watch the whole commercial. That's the Nate Land podcast is just about everything's a little too long. That's the kind I would say is a good. It's every comment's a little rolls out a little farther than it should.
All right. So do you have anyone that people have told you that you look like?
I had the only ones I remember is like Chandler. I think
from Friends.
I would get that like early on, like you know, like before I had a beard or anything. Like back my early when you've ever seen my videos I post on Instagram, the ones that are always old. Yeah. Like I would get it back then, and then I don't remember what else.
All right, so we asked people to share a few. So this guy's from Reno 911, Thomas.
Yeah.
I forgot his last name.
You know what? I think I have heard him.
Yeah, yeah. A few people said that.
You guys, what's the guy's name?
Thomas Lennon.
Thomas Lennon, that's right.
Yeah, very funny guy. Reno 911, extremely underrated show. If you haven't ever watched Reno 911, it's amazing, man. It's so funny. And still very funny. Mm-hmm. Still holds up. So, you know, go all watch right. Reno now.
From Sopranos.
All right.
Oh, the son from The Sopranos?
Yeah.
I get Aaron Paul sometimes. I remember when I did a Tonight Show, I'd get Aaron Paul.
There was one Aaron Paul, I think, submission. Yeah. But a few for the... why am I forgetting his name on The Sopranos? But you guys know it.
Yeah. Nick Novicki, my buddy Nick, little person, was on... I was in Sopranos with him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. When he auditioned for it, Nick was staying at my house, and my wife auditioned with him. Like we'd read she'd read the lines with him.
Oh, that's cool.
And then because he was on that. He was on the other.
AJ Soprano was his name on there.
Yeah.
Someone said this Stanley Kubrick.
I mean that one. I mean definitely. You've done a good job picking the pictures out.
I was going to say, yeah.
The viewer actually, or listener actually picked this one out.
Yeah.
But.
They did very good.
Yeah. Yeah. He did that one. So.
That one's good. Yeah. That's the stand-ups I felt very bloated.
This is my favorite one. Someone sent me this. Is a guy from 1862. And I think that could be your great, 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 great grandfather. Look at that guy.
Yeah.
Who is that? Do you know who that guy is?
Yes, yes, yes. And again, if you're listening, we're going to post all this stuff.
Yeah.
Andrew Myrick. He was a trader who, with his Dakota wife, operated stores in South.
A good trader, though. T-R-A-D-E-R.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Clarify that.
Someone who trades.
Yeah.
So he did not have a good ending. It's not on here, but I read about this. The Dakota Indians asked him for some food, and he was like, "Just go eat grass." He was not very helpful to them. And then the Dakota Wars broke out, and he died on the first day, and they found him with grass stuffed in his mouth and in some other areas of his body. So they remembered that.
So he started the U.S. – he started the war?
I don't know if he started it, but they remembered him. When it broke out, they're like, let's find that guy. Let's find the guy that told us to eat grass. Yeah. So he had a
– I mean, you probably started it if they're going to do that.
They sought him out, that's for sure.
But he said to eat grass sarcastically, not as legitimate
– could that be your great-great-great –
Grand. That honestly could. That could be some kind of tie, you know.
Mm-hmm. And he had two thumbs.
Yeah. If he's 0% Italian, it might be my guy. That's pretty wild.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's uncanny.
That's crazy. That looks like if I posted that picture and said I'm doing a movie.
Yeah.
And sent you that, you'd be like, wow, dude, that looks great. Like,
just shave the mustache, get the goatee. Get the swoosh, and the next picture you don't have the swoosh.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. So all right. So I'll post that. I'll share all that. So then I was reading about doppelgangers. Do we all have a doppelganger? And I don't know if you guys have read about this or not. The article said that there's a 1 in 135 chance that we have a doppelganger, which to me makes, that seems pretty low.
Yeah.
But then they did a study and said for all 8 major facial features, it's 1 in a trillion, which is...
To be a perfect...
A perfect match. A
perfect doppelganger.
So, yeah, you and Mike White...
I mean, that's probably...
Y'all have to be...
That's probably 7 out of 8.
Yeah.
I was going to say you six, know? But all right.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty close.
Yeah.
All right. So yeah, 1 in 135 is what they said.
Do the order up there, whatever.
Of the show?
Yeah.
All right. And then...
So 1 out of 135, how many of those 8 characteristics? So like a near perfect doppelganger, there's a 1 in 135.
Yeah, I don't know chance. How many of those facial features has to be for that, but
I mean, I would say like if you have, I mean that guy that you just showed,
yeah,
mm-hmm.
like that has to be.
You talking about the old guy?
Yeah, my guy, my Civil War guy, or the guy that started the U.S. Dakota War.
Yeah.
Hey, the guy's making differences, whether it's good or bad. Yeah. His name's in the paper, and that's what it's about.
So this was a 2015 study by researchers in Australia. One in 100
study stuff, man. You know, that's what how do researchers
of all state?
Like, how are you ever even kind of getting some data
on this, or just in general?
On this in general. How is stuff even happen?
I don't know how it works.
How do you even get started?
I don't know how you pick, like, you pick this as your specialty. Yeah. I'm going to look into doppelgangers.
Yeah, I wonder how many there are. And, like, how could you ever in a million years?
So they studied 4,000 different faces from a database and just analyzed all the similarities. They said they didn't disclose what those 8 facial features are. I'm curious what they look at, you know?
Hmm.
Maybe
what would be
like their
eyebrows, yeah, the cheek, yeah. Like the bone structure of the face.
I'm sure you can guess close enough. It's probably close enough.
I mean,
I think we get 4 eyes, nose, yeah. Mouth, ears. Yeah. What's the other
the rest? Is like that seems weird that they didn't why would they?
That's
not
why
disclose
I think
it?
There's like a secret one they're looking at,
yeah,
like that just makes it obvious.
It's like the thing that, like, you know, like they would say, like, a cop can tell. If you're drunk or not, it was like your eye, like if your eyes, if there's any hesitation.
Oh, really?
Like when they do the thing, if you have a, if it's not, if there's a pause, then that's how they can tell.
Oh, interesting.
I think, and like, so it's like that. Like, that's what I mean. Like, it's something so, like, that's like a thing that you would never, like, I didn't know that. So you're thinking, well, what are they doing? How do they know?
Yeah.
And you're like, well, if there's something that obvious.
Mm-hmm. And they're not actually looking for what you think they're looking for.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, you're trying to be still and stare at the person and all this.
Mm-hmm.
And all he needs to see is, like, a little hesitation when you follow the pen.
That's what I'm saying. I'm thinking about what my eyes look like, but really they're looking for that little thing under the nose.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know.
Yeah.
So that study didn't say what the 8 facial features was. Speaking of studies, so we all watched 3 Identical Strangers documentary.
Yeah, so this episode is like, we kind of thought about that. We're like, because we were talking about, you get brought up who you look like, especially when we started this, and people started saying what we look like in doppelgangers. And then got us thinking about, like, being twins and, you know, like, who do we have all these people that look alike? So it is. We watched, I watched it last night, 3 Identical Strangers, which we should post to tell people to watch it if they want to watch. It's on Hulu.
Okay. I watched it on Amazon Prime.
Yeah, me too.
I watched it on Hulu last night, and it kept stopping. For some reason, my Hulu, every 30 minutes, it would just go black, and then I'd have to wait.
Amazon Prime was fine.
Yeah, almost didn't make it through it. I actually kept doing it.
They weren't ads? I mean, they have ads.
I know. Maybe Hulu. That's why.
Yeah.
Was it? No, I don't know.
I don't know either.
But yeah, they would just go black screen, and then if I left it on, it would cut back on.
So if you haven't seen it, it's
pulling over, huh?
It's a nature versus nurture, basically, documentary.
Yeah.
It's these first 2 brothers meet, realize they're twins. Guy goes to college at the beginning. Everyone thinks he's someone
else.
It's
crazy, yeah.
And then they're like all yelling his name. And then one of them who knows the guy, like, oh my gosh, calls that other guy. They go and meet. So for a while.
That night.
Yeah. So for a while.
I don't think he went back to college.
Maybe not.
Like, it seemed like...
They never talked about it, did
they? Yeah, because he enrolled in this college, and then everybody's like, Eddie, they keep calling him by his name. He's like, girls are kissing him, and he's like just a guy. His name's Bobby, and he's like, I don't know what's going on. Like, and then the guy says, no, you look like this. And they it's according to, like, maybe it's just for the storytelling of it, but it seemed... But, I mean, I'd imagine... If you're that convinced, you are going to be like, we got to go figure this out now.
If everyone's saying
it. Everybody's saying it, and they drove to Eddie's house.
Got pulled over on the way there because they were speeding. The guy's like, I'm going to go meet my twin brother.
Yeah.
They meet. So then a newspaper does a story about how they finally met. And then a third twin brother, a triplet, excuse me.
If you're older, it seems like it was a story. I mean, this was the 80s. I don't remember. But like they, if you're, you know... If you're older, someone, this is how we found out about the story. Brian just said, I remember once in the news.
I was watching Donahue.
Donahue, which was crushing it, dude. They have, that dude, there's 1,000 or 1,500 people in that Donahue when they interview them.
Yeah.
Like, Donahue was the biggest show on earth.
Oh, like an arena that they did that interview. Yeah.
It was like enormous. I mean, people are like asking these questions. Like, Donahue is... I wasn't even putting it together that it was Donahue because it was so, I thought it was almost like a church or something. Yeah. And I was putting it together, then you realize, you're like, golly, dude, this was a regular show.
Yeah.
They were on everything.
What year did this take place?
Like the 80s.
Okay. Mid-80s, like 85.
Do either of y'all remember?
No. I mean, I was born in 79.
Okay.
I did watch Donahue, so I'm with my grandparents, but I don't remember that.
Yeah, okay. I was curious how, you know...
I would say my parents would remember it.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying if they remember the story, but they would definitely would. Okay. I mean, everybody remembered those stories. But these guys seem... I bet my parents would remember it. I mean, I was born in 79, so my parents were 22 or 3 when they had me. Like,
yeah.
So they would have... And it was just a mega, mega story. And this is obviously when, you know, with no internet, this is when stories were like... If you were on every... Like they said in the thing, they went viral.
Yeah.
To go viral in that time frame. Where people, nothing was going viral, but you're just like every channel, every station, every newspaper, back when people read newspapers. I mean, the one guy said, this is how much newspapers made then. He said, I want to go get a plane and fly to go meet. Because when they first was a twin, when he said these two twins found out about each other, he goes, let's get a plane and let's go fly there. That's how good the newspapers were doing, that they just had a private plane to go like just check on this story. Yeah. Like, that's crazy. Yeah. Like, you know, and now these papers have nothing.
They could maybe get a rental car.
Maybe. You know? And they'd be like, I don't know, you pay for the gas, but we're economy.
Yeah.
And then make sure you fill the gas. They would be furious if you filled it up at the rental car place. Or, I mean, that would be, you just would probably be fine. They're like, we can't afford $6 a gas, dude. So
then they become big celebrities, and, but then their parents, who are from obviously three different families, they're like, why did we not know? And they go and meet with the adoption agency, and they're like, well, we split them up because we didn't, adopting triplets would be so hard, and we thought it'd be easier to, which, I don't know.
That makes sense to me. I think it was a good enough answer even for the parents to be like, okay, I understand that. Like, where the parents left, like, it's not the answer they wanted, but for them to say, like, yeah, if you have triplets, then it's not gonna like it's a not every family can take that. Like they want one, and then they're like, well, we have three. And I mean, maybe you should be trying to find a home that would.
Yeah, I mean,
think you could.
One of the dads said I would have taken all three, and they did leave trying to seek a lawsuit against this adoption agency. But the adoption agency, none of the law firms would take the case because they were people from their firm were trying to adopt from this place.
Yeah,
and then they find out later on that it was part of a study. Some researcher was doing a study on separating twins at birth to see how they would act as they grow older, nature versus nurture. So it was a big, big conspiracy.
And the three families that adopted these triplets were all varying like income levels.
Lower class, middle class, upper class.
And had taken in adopted kids.
Mm-hmm.
Like had three, all of them had an adopted like girl in their each family.
Older
sister. All those boys had older sisters, and all of them were adopted. So it was, I mean, it was a complete study that they were like trying to do. And like, you know, it's, You know the older lady in it that has all the pictures wearing the yellow, like very kind of. I think, is she evil? Like
the lady that did part of the research?
Yeah. I was like it's her. You're going like, is she one of like the evil ones? Like,
yeah, I mean,
she
yeah.
seemed like it, but it's like they're interviewing. She just does not care,
no.
And like very nonchalant, and like seems like to have had an amazing career, and she just talked about it like, oh, I don't care. Like, you know, she's like, should they know? Should they not know? Like, supposedly these records, you're not allowed to open them for 100 years, basically 105 years, I think was the, and they basically wanted to make sure all these. Whoever's in this 2066, so who? Which I was trying, how old? I'll, what is it? 2020. That's 46 more years. Oh, I'll be super old. I'll be 86 or 87. Me and you will just be the only ones left on this podcast. You know who?
I mean, y'all probably both outlive me.
I'll be aware of it. There's more than likely that's true.
Yeah.
Once you do the Krispy Kreme thing, once you start giving in, you're like, I'll eat these donuts in front of everybody. And you're like, ah, he's gone, dude. So they talked to that lady, and she was like, you know, is it better for them to know that they have a twin? Because it seems that they, you know, like, the kids knew. They can tell, which is very unbelievable that identical twins or triplets, like they just have something's drawing them to, I mean, it's pretty crazy. Like the idea of all of this, where these, like how they're drawing to, you know, like they can, they all were like banging their heads against the wall when they were kids and like all this kind of crazy stuff. Cause they were just getting, cause they got pulled apart. But when they talk to that old lady, I mean, she just blows it off and like just is like, whatever. Like, it's like, we did it for this study. But that's what the one guy that kind of figured all this out, where he's like, why? Well, if it's so important of a study, then release the stuff. Like, what did you learn from it? If there was this, you know, the cat's out of the bag. We all know that this was a study.
Yeah.
But I mean, they said there's probably 4 to 6 still twins that don't know.
That are probably still out there from that same program.
That don't know that they have a twin.
Wow.
The same idea.
Yeah, that's one of those. It's like an interesting thing, an interesting experiment to run if you don't care about being evil.
If you don't care about human beings,
let's separate these triplets at birth and let's just see what happens.
Yeah.
You know, it's like we all kind of want to know, but you can't do it.
Yeah.
Right.
What if you had a twin?
It makes you think of that. Like, where you always think that, you always hear the stories of someone being adopted. Like, they're like, and I had no idea I was adopted. And then you're always like, was I adopted? Like, you think your parents are just going to come around the corner and be like, here's your other brother, Worf. There's a real Worf
out
there.
Maybe that description was right.
Maybe that description is right. I'd have a whole nother family.
Yeah.
That would be crazy. I wonder if there's, what surprise families, has anybody know anybody that's had a surprise? I mean, I guess they could have another family. And that would be gut-wrenching to find out. And that's got to be
that you were swapped. I know that was a problem for kids getting swapped at hospitals.
Yeah,
like newborns. You know,
that's why you marked their foot. What did we do for Harper?
Well, now don't they give you like a house arrest ankle bracelet now, right?
Yeah, I could see because these babies are. See, that's where people can do stuff like that. Where these scientists do this, like they're looking at humans. They don't look at them as like real. They look at them as like almost animals, like the way they would do this study on like monkeys or something.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I think those scientists look at people. Like they look at them as like, that's not a real person. They don't care. That with doctors have to have some side of that. They can't have emotion tied into being a doctor. Even the people with babies, like where they see babies all born. I'm sure a lot of them love these babies. But there has to be some disconnect. Or you can't do what you do.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to like do. And so like these people go into this science stuff. I don't think they can. I mean, that woman did not care that she did this.
The main researcher's dead, right?
Yeah.
I think he would probably still argue there's no way those kids were going to get adopted altogether. So we were doing them a favor.
Yeah. I don't think they were ever even attempting that. I think he would take that angle now.
Yeah.
Because he gets called out. But I don't think he would. I don't think it would have, like, they were doing the study, and, like, it was like, oh, yeah, we're just going to get, these kids are going to go 3 different places.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, you know, they gave them to 3 different homes, like, yeah. It very easily someone could be like, I'm not going to take these kids. But it seems like that place didn't have a problem with getting kids adopted. Like that, it seems like it was a higher, like, you know, it was a higher level of a place. Yeah. It's not like it was just regular foster homes or that kind of stuff.
Yeah,
which my sister does very wonderfully. She'll take in kids.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh, that's awesome.
And they, they get calls. You get called at 10 p.m. at night and be like, we got these kids. And you go. And then they had some just for the weekend, and then the kids will go to like a more concrete home after that. Yeah, it's very nice that she does that. Like, because it's a lot. I mean, you see, you know, we've met some of the kids and they come in and it's just sad. I mean, they just have no consistency in their life. And, you know, like they're raising each other. It's unbelievable. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, like some are 8-year old. I mean, like my daughter's 8 and I can't imagine. And there's kids that grow up where at 8, they're the most adult in the house.
Yeah.
Which is nuts.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. So anyway.
I mean, the documentary, it was basically about nature versus nurture. I don't know what what would you say the conclusion was?
I would say the conclusion was that, you know, for the sake of the story, they played up a lot of superficial similarities between these three guys. They all prefer the same brand of cigarettes.
Yeah.
You know, they like the same, they have the same taste in women.
Yeah.
That kind of stuff. But
very broad things, though. Like, Marlboro is like the number one. You're like,
exactly. It's like saying they all like Coca-Cola the best. It's, you know, of course they do.
Yeah.
But
in the end, they kind of admitted that.
They admitted, that those were all superficial differences in that. Because they grew up in such different environments, they were more different than even they wanted to admit.
Yeah.
So I think the conclusion was that nurture was ultimately more important in the things that mattered.
Yeah. Right.
You know?
Right.
Yeah.
It's a good study. I'm glad they did it.
Honestly, worth it in the end. Honestly. Because we all learned something.
The way you just broke it down, I think we should do it again. It is true. That is funny, though. It is, like, truthfully, you get it. But that's the thing is, like, go get the – at least don't make what they did pointless. Then show the results. Show, like, you know, it's like make it like a study. We did the study. Mm-hmm. Here's the guys that did it. Here's all the kids that were forced into this that have no choice. So here's the result. That's the problem, too, that I think almost that's what even ends up being – we already have a problem – you know, like that lady said, and I get it, in the 60s, 61, there's no concept of like, we're doing this to kids. No, I mean, that's another world than what you're living in right now.
Mm-hmm.
But it's at least showed the result. Like, that's why are they being, like, it's like, that's the stuff that gets weird to be like, they're like, oh, they showed it, but it's heavily redacted. No one, so it's like hard to piece together, like, all the stuff. That's the stuff that becomes the problem where you go, like, then just make it like, just show it, dude. What can possibly be on there that's worse than what we know?
Yeah.
I mean, unless there is. But like, that's the part you're like, what would be worse?
Yeah.
You know, like, it's like they have, that's what someone said, like they had a fourth one. And then there's like, there was a quadruple. You're like,
that's the only thing that could
shock you. He was watching the doc.
He was watching the documentary and saw.
Yeah.
That's me.
Dude, that's hilarious. You know, it was
he smokes Camel. And they're like, well, that can't be him. Like that.
He likes redheads.
Yeah. Like, well, that's, then get out of here, man. Yeah,
dude. Stop trying to latch on to this.
They look just like him, though. It's crazy. Those guys didn't age super well, I'll tell you that.
No.
I mean, they were young, good-looking guys, strapping, good-looking boys.
Yeah.
And that, I mean, when you see them, I know, because when you first get them interviewed, you're like, and they're like, there was like Eddie was getting kissed by everybody. You're like, and you're looking at him going, what?
Yeah.
You're like, this dude was, I mean, just women are just kissing him like as he makes. And then you see the pictures. You're like, oh, yeah, these dudes are unbelievable. Yeah. Like, they're just big guys, great hair, like big, big smile. All of them had gigantic smiles.
Yeah.
And then you're like, well, that makes sense. Mm-hmm. But when they're interviewing them there, you're like, what?
It's funny how one of the guys is no longer alive, but the other two now, they don't look that much alike anymore. I mean, they still do, but
just a little bit.
But no ways like when they were younger.
Did you realize that they weren't interviewing the other brother?
I didn't think about it until they told me.
Do you want to say the spoiler? Or what?
Well, I mean, we've, it's already, I mean, I think we're... say, obviously, if you listen to this, this is a spoiler, I mean, afterwards. I think it's been out for a few years now.
Yeah, like one of the three brothers committed suicide.
That's great, Aaron.
We weren't going to say it.
We can't just reference it without explaining it.
But something happens to the third brother.
Okay, yeah, my bad. I don't know what.
It's a family-friendly podcast. Yeah.
But I think that those so much of how you look is not just genetics, but like your environment and what happens to you over time, right?
He committed suicide, and then the third brother. I didn't realize that they weren't showing him at first. I think because you kind of keep seeing them, and you're like. I remember right before they do a really good job of telling the story of this, but before they reveal that he did commit suicide, you start right before you get to that point, you're like, have I seen the other brother? Like, you just can't really remember if you've seen him.
Yeah.
And so when they reveal that, I forgot what I was going to say. I lost my train of thought.
Let's just wait for him.
George Costanza. I mean, Frank, he's like,
what if he had just like held out for more money? Like, that's the reason he wasn't. Was that he wasn't in it.
They just couldn't afford him for the documentary. Yeah.
He's like, no. So, all right, we'll say we killed him off.
Well, another thing is twins and triplets were much less common back then. That's one of the things we were talking about beforehand. Like, it's way more common now for a number of reasons. Right?
Yeah. I know a lot of, I don't know any triplets. I know a lot of twins. You guys know? I have a lot of friends that are twins.
Mm-hmm. I don't.
Yeah, I have a.
I don't know if I
went to school with a few sets.
We had my mom had two twin sisters, but they died maybe 4 months old. Oh wait, no,
no, they're still alive.
Hold on,
I saw them at Christmas. My bad.
You know what? They were in that perfect stranger. Like I just went, wait a second. No, my mom had a. A baby died that would have been her. Maybe my dad had a twin and then died in birth. I gotta get to the bottom of that.
I was gonna say, probably.
Did you know what the show was gonna be about today? It seemed like something maybe you'd have looked into.
I know. Well, I didn't think about it until right now when you said you know twins.
My dad's a twin.
I think, I don't remember.
Well, I had a bunch of.
That's not my Netflix documentary, would be that. It's better than my dad's a principal.
I know a bunch of twins. Now, the article that says that twins are more prevalent in the world now, one, because people are having children older.
Yeah.
And just, even if it's natural, you're more likely to have twins or triplets. And then the other reason is because people are having older, fertility treatments are a big reason why people.
Yeah, I know there's a, I know people that have twins. A lot.
All right, now we're talking.
It's, and I think it's that that treatment that they do, IF, right?
In vitro.
Like, yeah, it almost seems like it's almost guaranteed twins, like, which is the greatest way you could do it as a parent. Just to go get a boy and girl. Some of the guys that they get a boy and girl, and then they're out, same time, out. They get two kids at one.
The Octomom had eight.
Huh?
The Octomom, you remember her?
Yeah. She got famous. She got famous like those three identical strangers got famous.
Yeah.
Like
that's interesting. That's a good comparison of like how big the story was.
Yeah.
Kind of. Yeah.
Yeah. Octomom is in gigantic. I mean, they were the tabloids were following around. Like, I mean, it's like, what is she up to? And and I think that's what's so hard for all of them is they go from being a regular regular person to the most famous, can't go anywhere. So I mean, you're watching. You know, it's like so we talk about like celebrity a lot, like with when you're seeing like Brad Pitt or whoever, we're Tom Cruise, they know how to be a celebrity, like they know like the world, and so when someone gets completely normal, like nothing at all, and then just thrown in to the next day, they can't go outside and they're the most famous. That's a gigantic. Leap just to go, you don't have any training, you know what I mean? Like, it was like you don't have any experience up to that. Like, that's where they talk about that thing about pulling those babies apart is they don't get that like experience together, like, they don't get like experience is so everything, man. I'm a big fan of experience, like, it's experience is something that gets overlooked, and but they experience completely, you know, completely matters, and so. They didn't get that. But when they get in, like, so they didn't get to be the experience of learning to be famous. And then they're just super famous, which is then why everything kind of crumbles, that they can't, because you can't keep up with it. There's no reasoning. There's no, you know, you're like, it's, everything's just such a shock that, mm-hmm. you know, I don't know.
Especially if you're a kid, like a
oh, yeah, 19, famous child. Dude. Yeah, I mean, like, insane.
Yeah, the Octomom, I looked her up. Her kids are now 11 and doing all right.
All 8 of them yeah. are still? Wow.
Yeah. She got kind of criticized when all that happened, but they're doing all right.
Well, yeah, because she had 8 kids.
Yeah.
People were mad about that.
Yeah.
What she had, and she did it like.
Because she had some embryos implanted and. Yeah. And,
like she was trying to have 8 kids.
She was trying to have 8, I would think.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, she was trying to increase her chances of having kids, yeah. and so uh-huh. they all came out.
Oh, but she wasn't planning on 8.
She didn't think they'd all make it.
Yeah.
Oh, really? I always thought she was gunning for 8.
I mean, I don't think so. You thought she was going for the record?
Yeah.
Is that the record? I bet there's...
No, that's the record. There was one in Australia that had 9, but one of them died at birth, so 8's the...
I think there were one woman gave birth to over 60 kids over the course of her... Not at once, but over the course of her life.
Well, that's not what we're talking about here.
I'm just saying.
If she had 60...
I remember that. 8's the record at once. So, man.
Do you find it weird, though, that twins generally, they always look the same throughout the progression? Their body types stay the same? They're... Like, if one of them's physically fit, they'll both be physically fit. If one of them lets themselves go, they'll usually both let themselves go.
But they were... I mean, and that one, I mean, Bobby and David were 2 different sizes.
As adults?
Yeah, as adults. I mean, Bobby seemed like he was like slim, and then David seemed like he was still stout and big.
Yeah, I just, that's true. I know twins, when they're little, their parents dress them alike and they look alike. But then I know a lot of twins who, even as adults, look very similar. Usually,
really?
Because genetics is the same, I guess, as far as your metabolism.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Well, all of them, when all 3 of those brothers got together, I mean, they were the same size.
Yeah.
They looked exactly the same. Same size, same build, you know.
Well, they were all in like college age where your peak physical, you know, everything.
Yeah, one of them had a little bit shorter hair, and then I noticed he let it grow out pretty quick.
Who?
One of the triplets.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I was looking at the, you guys remember these guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
I mean,
the McGuire twins. These are the
Aaron, do you ever get recognized for these guys? From the back?
Just one of them. Just.
Well, you should have a picture of them with Aaron sitting backwards in a chair.
All right, I want to be clear. They weighed about 750 pounds each.
Yeah.
You're the one. I don't think you're
listen,
a big guy.
I know you guys like to clown on me, but I actually am a good piano player. So
one of them weighed 723 and the other one weighed 745. You think the 723 guy was like, come on, man, you got to get your life together. What are you doing?
Trashing the
other guy. He's like...
When they sit there with a doctor, and the doctor's like, you guys got to lose weight. And the 723 guy's looking, he's like, he's talking to you, man. I mean, like, he's not talking to me. I mean...
So it's like, what are you doing, man?
At that point, you're losing 20 pounds is nothing. Like, losing 20 pounds of them is nothing.
You probably fluctuate 20 pounds every night, like when you sleep.
Yeah, maybe.
When you're that big.
Yeah.
You know, because I fluctuate 5 or 6 pounds probably every night.
You think the 745 was, hey, man, what are you doing? I'm doing the all-meat diet.
Yeah.
No, man, I heard that's not good for you.
I mean, they were, these two guys.
And they're professional wrestlers. I didn't know that, but there's some video of them in the ring.
You know, it's ironic. They're famous for that picture of the two of them on motorcycles.
Yeah.
One of them died in a motorcycle accident.
Yep. Yep.
Which, I mean, it could not
How
have been
could
easy
you
to
ever get. Yeah. What kind of motorcycle did you get going? Like, what was built?
Well, I mean, one of those, probably.
How, I mean, talk about a motorcycle. I mean, 730 pounds on top of you.
Yeah.
This motorcycle, I'd love to interview that motorcycle.
They weren't going fast, I'll tell you that much. They were not going fast.
I mean, yeah. It's like he died. Like, it's like that kind of like where you just see him like go, and then he tips. Like, it's just like a wiggly line. I mean, just if you don't get going right, then they tip.
They love the motorcycles.
You see those, the speed racing motorcycles?
When did they die? The heaviest twins. We're looking at the heaviest twins.
One of them outlived the other one by like 30 years, I think.
One of them died in 1979 at age 32.
Yeah.
A motorcycle accident. And the other one died recently. A
falling accident en route to Ripley's Believe It or Not. He lived 21 more years, 54, died in 2001 of just heart failure. Wow. 54 is unreal to live.
To be that big, yeah.
Yeah. Are they from Tennessee?
No, Hendersonville, North Carolina.
Oh. The grave is marked by a 13-foot-wide granite headstone, which is believed to be the largest in the world. Yeah, I mean, that's amazing. Crazy. I mean...
When do you think you decide, let's go for the record?
Yeah.
You know?
I don't think they decide, like...
At a certain point, they're like, "Let's lean. This is all we got. Let's lean into it."
No, yeah. I don't think they ever lean into it. I think
around 500, they looked at each other and like,
said, "We can do it."
Yeah,
I think you stumble into that record, and I think when you're that big, I think someone, and I think it takes a person a long time before they say it, but then someone does eventually just go like, "Hey, like I'm not trying to be rude, but like you guys, honestly, have a chance to be the heaviest people in the world." And someone has, and they're like, "What?" I mean, especially back then when they did it, someone had to been like, they bring over the Guinness Book of World Records. You probably got to have one friend that's like willing to be like, "I'll tell them." Like you probably have your outside friends are going like a, because there's a, they crossed into a point when you get to like 400, mm-hmm. 500. I mean, now you're. Friends, no one's like even saying like you should lose weight. Like, I mean, there's, you know, I mean, what are you gonna say? Like, what are you doing, man? You get out much? Like, these guys, I mean, honestly, were pretty active for that much. They rode motorcycles. They wrestled. Like, they were out and about.
Yeah,
you would have thought they would have just started trimming down.
That's what makes me think they were trying for this.
I think they leaned into
it. I don't think they just looked up one day and were like, "Oh, we're the fattest twins in the world." How did that happen?
I think they did.
Wow.
I think you would have just thought like that you are the fattest twin. Like I you're just big.
But do you think they kept track of other twins that were gaining weight? Like, the Jones boys are gaining on us.
They just didn't like them.
Yeah.
They go, "Yeah, but they're
Come on, man, we got to do something."
They go, yeah, I don't know. I mean, Andre, how much did Andre the Giant weigh?
He didn't weigh that much. He probably weighed 500-600 pounds, right?
But he was less than that. I think like 400 pounds, right?
Yeah,
but he was. Yeah,
he was so tall.
Look that up. How much Andre the Giant weighed?
Yeah. So he was. I mean, Andre. I mean, he died. All the stories of him drinking.
520 pounds.
7'4" though, which is a huge.
Yeah,
hill.
I mean that's pretty big.
Yeah.
My God.
And he had a twin. Did you guys know that?
That would be amazing. I almost did.
There are celebrity twins that you're like, boy, how did that... who were we talking about?
Yeah, they're not good. Go to the topics again. Like the...
Scarlett Johansson?
Yeah, she has a twin brother.
Yeah, she has a twin brother.
You knew that?
I knew. No. We talked about it before.
It's not that...
Elvis had one.
Elvis had a twins is the craziest on the list of the
celebrity
twins.
Well, he died at, he was stillborn, so.
Yeah, so, but it's like, that's the one that's kind of a shock.
Scarlett Johansson. That's a big what like, if Elvis Presley had a twin.
What if he.
Equally talented, charismatic guy was out there as well.
Yeah, that's. Mm-hmm.
Would they have been do you think they would have been a duo act? Or do you think they would have branched off and done different
things? What if he had made it over Elvis?
You know, maybe. I mean, maybe he would have been the more talented of the two.
That's the nature and the nurture. That's what the whole point of the study is. You know what they should do? They should do a study like that. They should just kill the other twin. Like that. That's what we're going to find out. That is what's crazy, though, is, you know, because if you would have heard that three identical strangers, if someone told you that, you found out to that, and someone was like, "Hey, they're still in, like, twins," that would be something that you would be like, "Well, that's a conspiracy theory, and you're being mm-hmm. ridiculous." Like, you know, that's that crazy of a thing. That you would like go like, well, that, because it does sound like a conspiracy theory. And then when you find out it's true that they're doing it. So, I mean, that's where the conspiracy theory is, like when they get stuff, you're like, some of it is true. I mean, if someone just said we're stealing, they're having triplets and twins being born, and then they're separating them to see what happens in their life.
Yeah.
You would never believe that.
Yeah.
I wouldn't believe that before I knew about this documentary, I wouldn't have. If you told me that that happened, I'd be like, well, no.
If you told me like you knew about that, I'd be like, hey, dude, if you ever need to talk, yeah, just let me know. Like,
yeah,
hope you're doing okay.
And then
I mean, it sounds crazy. Yeah.
And that's what the conspiracy theory is.
Napoleon Dynamite has a twin brother?
Yeah. Yeah, they're all. Parker and Christopher Posey. I know Tiki and Rondé Barber were twins. They.
It's always interesting when one athlete does way better than the other one.
They both have pretty good careers, though.
Well, not those guys particularly, but there's some athletes that one does much better.
Who? Like who in particular?
Let's move on.
Okay. I mean, what was that? That was, yeah, you know, you meant them.
Well.
Yeah.
And then when you then realized.
Tiki was a lot.
They did actually have okay careers.
Rondé was a good player. Tiki was much more.
Oh, Tiki had some big years, though. Like, I mean.
Tiki's what I'm saying. Tiki was the better.
Yeah, but then Rondé stayed longer and then was.
One of them retired early, didn't
he? Tiki retired early. Then Rondé, okay. Like, stayed longer and played for Tampa and, like, was a solid player. Like, you know, wasn't, like, just a hanger-on of the NFL. Like, started for Tampa and did great. I think did better after Tiki left. Tiki was just more known with being the Giants, but they both had solid careers.
Well, like, I looked up the tallest twins ever, and one of them, they're, like, both, like, 7'6 or something. One of them went to play at UCLA, and the other one went to the University of Denver.
To play.
Yeah. But it's a little bit, you know, UCLA's got a little bit more history there.
Yeah.
But that's interesting, because they're twins. They're genetically gifted in the same way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So does that mean that one just worked that much harder than the other one?
Well, we should do a study. Let's see what happens. All right, what are we at?
We're at time, right? A minute 10. So, out of 10.
All right. I think that's it.
Yeah. We're going to talk real quick about the parallel universe. And
I want to do that on a whole. We'll do that on the another episode because that's probably pretty fun.
All right.
And then we can figure out a rapid to talk about a little teaser. But is there a parallel universe with another you out there? Like, do you have a you or is us? Is there this podcast being done in a parallel in another universe? That's been probably done better. I mean, a lot of people are like, that's where I listen. I'd rather listen to the other that version that of it. But that seems like that could be its own kind of into the space and universe and pretty fun.
All right.
Pretty fun stuff. We'll tackle that next week on Nateland. Make sure you subscribe. We've had great comments, great ratings I mean, everybody's been super nice and we truly appreciate it. We do notice that. And that means a lot to us. So thanks for doing that. Thanks for listening. And we'll see you next week. All right.